to introduce somebody that is very dear to me. I just got to meet her backstage, and I am a little starstruck. So here's her intro. Sick of the corporatization of the recording industry, our next guest launched her own label to distribute new artists, Righteous Babe Records. Please welcome longtime activist and recording artist, the Righteous Babe herself, Ani DiFranco.
The masses of us marching along, we're seeming so much more life-affirming today than those with the bloody pictures shouting shame, shame, guilt, guilt, shame, guilt. It's like, pro-life, which is what has it? My favorite sign today was the one that just said, trust women. I thought that just said it all. State trooper thinks I drive too fast. Pull me over to tell me so. I say out here on the prairie, any speed is too slow. I miss Brooklyn, I miss my crew. Let's start over, I miss my cue. Guess I forgot who I was talking to. Should've recognized that fierce look in his eye. I've seen it in my mirror so many times. He's gonna put his two cents in, cause he's got a gun. But I'm gonna put in three, cause history owes me one. So I came out here to see some stuff for myself. I mean, why leave the telling up to everybody else? This may be God's country, but this is our country too. Yeah, move over, Mr. Holiness, let the little people through. And thanks for serving and protecting the likes of me. Yeah, thanks for the ticket. Now can I leave? You know I have left everywhere that I have ever been. I don't really recommend it though, not like anybody asked me. And maybe you and I will meet again someday. Yes, I've been known to come down this road. Maybe it's destiny, then again, maybe not. Sleep deprivation regimen to, in solidarity with the organizers of this shindig. Beautiful day. I thought I'd offer you a little poetry, just cause. A little out of tune poetry. I love my country. By which I mean, I am indebted joyfully to all the people throughout its history who have fought the government to make right. Where so many cunning sons and daughters, our foremothers and forefathers, came singing through slaughter, came through hell and high water so that we could stand here and behold breathlessly the sight how a raging river of tears cut a grand canyon of light. Yeah, I've been a lot of places now, flown through vast empty spaces with stewardesses whose hands look much older than their faces, and I've tossed so many napkins into that big hole in the sky, been at the bottom of the Atlantic seething in a two-ply, looking up through all that water and the fishes swimming by, and I don't always feel lucky. But I'm smart enough to try, 'cause humility has buoyancy and above us only sky. So I lean in, breathe deeper that brutal burning smell that surrounds the smoldering wreckage that I've come to love so well. Color me stunned and dazzled by all the red, white, and blue flashing lights in the American intersection where black crashed head on with white. Comes a melody, comes a rhythm, a particular resonance that is us and only us. Comes a screaming ambulance and a hand that you can trust, laid steady on your chest, working for the better good, which is good at its best. And two, bearing witness, like a woman bears a child with all her might, born of the greatest pain, into a grand canyon of light. And because no song has gone unsung here, and this joint is strung crazy tight, and people have been raising up their voices since it just ain't been right, with all the righteous rage and all the bitter spite that will accompany us out of this long night, that will grab us by the hand when we are ready to take flight, seat back and tray table in the upright, and shot a locked up to shocked position, shocked to tears by each new vision of all that my ancestors have done. Like, say, the women who gave their lives so that I could have one. Yes, we inhabit ground zero of the feminist revolution. People, it was an inside job, stoic and sly, one we're supposed to forget and downplay and deny. But I think the time is nothing, if not nigh, to let the truth out. Coolest F word ever deserves a fucking shout. I mean, why don't all decent men and women call themselves feminists? Out of respect for those who fought for this? I mean, look around. We have this. Yes, I love my country. By which I mean, I am indebted joyfully to all the people throughout its history who have fought the government to make right, where so many cunning sons and daughters, our foremothers and forefathers, came singing through slaughter, came through hell and high water so that we could stand here and behold breathlessly the sight how a raging river of tears is cutting a grand canyon of light. Play one more folk song for you. And pass it on, pass it on. So many beautiful voices. Watching capitalism gone down democracy. It had this funny effect on me, I guess. I am cancer, I am HIV, and I'm down at the Blue Jesus Blue Cross Hospital, just looking up from my pillow, feeling blessed. Have monopolized the oxygen, so it's as easy as breathing for us all to participate. Yeah, everybody. it's hard to point and say there. So you just sit on your hands and quietly contemplate your next bold move. The next thing you're gonna need to prove to yourself. To make machines that are disposable and sell them 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 to seagulls flying in circles around one big right wing. Why? Oh, the left wing was broken long ago by the slingshot of COINTELPRO, and now it's so hard to have faith in anything. Especially our next bold move. The next thing we're gonna need to prove to ourselves. Its source, and then scream up the faucet till your face is hoarse, 'cause you're surrounded by a world's worth of things you just can't excuse. Well, you got the hard cough of a chain smoker, and you're at the Arctic Circle playing strip poker, and it's getting colder and colder every time you lose. So go ahead, make your next bold move. Tell us, what's the next thing we're gonna need to prove to ourselves? Oh, to ourselves. Thank you so much for listening to me. Thank you for a beautiful day. It's wonderful to be here with you.
Ladies and gentlemen, award-winning actor, director, and frequent advocate for women.